Welcome back to Harman's video part 2. In this video we will learn how to use generic algorithm using MATLAB software. We are using MATLAB software of version 8.3 of 2014. So let's start. As in earlier video we have talked about the artificial neural networking. So this time we will learn how to use generic algorithm. This is called a command window again, and this is the workspace and this is a library. First of all, we have to create a script form that is our fitness function. I already have created my fitness function. This is my fitness function, so let's copy. Here we will paste it. So you can see here the function y is equal to, that is we can rename, I will rename it as a Harman, and this is to the x variable. So here we have four responses and four input values. So this is the main equation which we can see here. This is y1, y2, y3 and y4. These all are with the intersection of the x-axis. So how we get this equation, that is all up to your fitness function, that how you create it. Now let's start. We have to use the command window now. First of all, we have to save this data. Let's save it. Remember one thing. When we save this data, always give the same name what we have given to the fitness function. Here I am mentioning it as a Harman. So I will save it. And if we see here, the y is equal to Harman x. If for example I take here that robot, so I will save it as a robot. Now we can see here the file is saved in the current folder. That is the library of the MATLAB. Now let's start using command window. We will use a tool, that is Optim tool. Which means the optimization tool. In the neural network we use NN tool, that is called neural networking tool. Here we are using Optim tool. First of all we will select the type of means algorithm we are using. Here we are using the generic algorithm, so I will select solver as generic algorithm. Now we can see here that we have selected the generic algorithm, and there are two types of generic algorithm, that is generic algorithm and multi objective optimization using generic algorithm. That is the both are the same thing, but the difference is that if we have the only one variable, I mean to say that if we have only a one response variable, then we will select this GA tool. If we have the multiple, more than two, then we will select here multi objective. So GA tool is a simple thing. I will here consider a multi objective because I also have four responses, so we will use GA multi objective. Now next we can see here the problem is fitness function, so let's input it at the rate Harman. Remember that we have considered the file name as Harman, so we will again consider it as a Harman. Now the number of variables we have taken four. Further, the constraints, linear inequalities, what we have to put up here. Bounds is the main and major thing here, we have to consider it. We will use a square bracket and we will put the bounds. This is the lower bounds and this is the upper bounds. Again, square bracket. And 16. So we can see here I have put the bounds, that's lower bound and upper bounds, and now let's iterate it. Now you can see here the optimization is running and the iteration value is also running here. So the final iteration value is 237. Now we can see here the pattern front is plotted here in the graphical form as the tabular form. From this table we can see it depicts that f1, f2, f3 and f4, f1, f2, f3 and f4, these are the values which are known as the response values. These are the optimum values. The first index is the optimum value for all the data. According to the genetic algorithm, this value is the optimum value. If operator needs to have f1 greater, we can select here. We can see here the optimum value is 186 at 1, x1, x2, x3 and x4. So if we need f2 as a major value, we can consider it while selecting it as a 19.435. Same moving further is that f3, f4 and so on. So now we can see here on the right hand side that population is given. These are the settings for the genetic algorithm. That is the main part on the left side, and this is the modification tools. So optimization tools we can say, and the population here is defined is as a double vector we consider here. Mainly the double vector is considered. There are two types of the population types. First one is double vector and second one is bit string. What is bit string? Now we can see, we will see here x, x2, x3 and x4. These are in the numbering form. Now if I select the bit string, it will decode the data. You can see here the data will be get changed. See, now the value are get changed 0101, or we can say it as a binary code number. We have just decoded the data. We named as the 1 as a 0 and 2 as the 1. Same here, the 30 is as a 0 and so on. So we'll consider double vector because I need the data as same as we considered it. Now you can see it again and come to its initial position by selecting the double vector. Moving further, we can see here the population size that is used by default 50. Now what is population size? The population size is the set. If we consider 18 variables, we can see here there are total 18 variables. Now if I need the more than the 100, 200 variables, I will specify here like 300 and up to so on. We can take it up to 1 lakh, but it all up to our need. But here we will use only 50 because I need a small data. I need a just optimum value. So next is creation function, that is uniform we have selected, and the best result is attained at the feasible population size. We will select here. These are the initial population and initial score range and so on. We also consider as a default value. That is nothing need to change it. Now next is selection for the tournament. There is only an option for the tournament, or if we need to have our own custom function, we can customize, and here we will rename, like here I have given that I did Harman. So we can, if we create a new script, and we can rename it as a robot, as we can always say that. That's all up to. Here we consider a tournament with a default value of 2 size. And the next is reproduction. So crossover fraction. This is the fraction due to which the whole data gets changed. You can see here the 0.8 value is taken and default value we can vary from this tool. I will consider 0.49. Now we can see there, this is a 79.626 again iteration is begin. See, the data is get changed each and every time the data get changed. See, the maximum value we have attained at the 150. Again 73. Now at 0.3, what happened here? 0.3. See, these are the valuable. We have to get change these all valuable up to our optimal solution, required solutions. So additionally, we can say here is a mutation tool also. Mutation function we have to consider as a uniform. There are also other some mutation function that is constraint dependent, Gaussian, uniform and adiabatic feasible. Again, I will say that uniform and adiabatic feasible is the most of the common used function because they have the high optimum value. So I will recommend that it is the most commonly used because I also worked on it, adiabatic feasible. Now crossover function. There are number of types of crossover functions. First is the constraint dependent. The constraint dependent is the, if we select upon here constraint dependent, we have to select upon here also as the constraint dependent. But here we have considered the feasible population, so I will select as a single point or 2 point scattering. But here we will set a single point. Now then is the migration. Migration are two types, forward and both. So here again we will say the forward is the best for this. Now the next one is for the multi-objective problem setting. That if we need any type of changes here, we can do here by specifying our new functions. But it is also, we don't need upon it. If we want to need upon, we can change also here. This is a petrol function, we can also specify it also here. The next is the hybrid function. Hybrid function is only one is given here, that is the F goal, attain value. If we have our own, again we can put it here. Now the next part is the major part here, we can see that is the stopping criteria for the iteration value, that is a generation that is used with default value as a 100 number of variable. For 100 number of variable, we have selected the 50 variables, so I will not change here more than the 100 because it's all default value. If I use the 300 value, then I will change this 100 generation because it is a probability for the all the data, it's a constant ratio. So I will maintain it as a 50 and this one as also as a 100. Now the time limit is infinity, taken as all the constant values. Now another part is here, plot function. Plot function is just graphically plot. So we can see here the distance plot here, start iteration, and now we can see here the average distance plot between the generation is plotted here, and I stop up to near about the 100. We have taken the 100 here, that's why it stop up to here. See, if we select other type of these all types of graphical plot, all up to need mostly petrol front and ranking. So let's do it all. You will see here, if I start here, it will create a whole graph. These are the function 1, 2, 3, 4 which we happen to consider here. And here is given a ranking system to all the individuals. And this objective 1 between objective 2 is plotted here in the star forms. The stopping criteria which we have selected there at 100 stall, here we can see it will stop up to here between 20, nearby 20. You can see here it stop at 200 and little bit near 20. We can say it as approximate 17 to 18. That is the criteria for meeting that. And the number of children's ranking is also here shown here. If we need a separate graph, we can select here and plot it in a different way. Now make a close view for this graph. We can see this is, if we zoom up here, see the number of scattered. Now how to export the data. This is my final values, the optimum value we attained here. Go to file, export to workspace, export it all. Okay, now go back to main value. Here we can see to the workspace. The problem is here. These are the problem fitness function at the Harman, and the result is here. That is x value, and this is the main function value which we have got. That is the optimum results. It will be about 18. See, these are all in all. I will say to use this software, MATLAB software, while using a genetic algorithm, I prefer the minimum PC requirement as the i3 processor. I am using i5 processor with the turbo booster of 3.10 gigahertz. So I recommend to use minimum of the i3 processor of minimum of 2 gigahertz and the RAM of minimum of 3 GB RAM. So thank you for watching the video. Bye bye.